A subtable is useful for handling forms with one-to-many relationships. For example, a purchase order with one customer's information and many items to be purchased. Or one class linked to a list of many students and their corresponding contact information. A list of many contacts for one company. Or one customer and many pieces of ski equipment in a rental agreement. In Ragic, fields like the order number, customer name, etc. are the one in the one-to-many relationship. These fields are usually aligned vertically at the top of the form. One field header corresponds to one field value, and the field value is to the right of the header. However, often we need to include multiple line items within a record. We use a subtable to record the many in the one-to-many relationship. For instance, if I create a purchase order form, I would record the order date and customer information in the headers at the top of the page, and all the items included in the order will go below in a subtable. Let's go through an example of a purchase order. Start with all the basic information, such as the order number, date, customer name, phone, address, and so on. You might notice that I usually add a new field below the previous field. Alternatively, you can add another header to the right of the white field value cell. Now, we will create the subtable. It's a little different from creating a normal independent field. First, click in a cell and type the first field header title of the subtable. Then, in the next field to the right, where its field value would typically go, type another field header title. The system will recognize this as a subtable and will automatically arrange the field values vertically below the field headers. As you add more field names, notice that the field headers must be placed next to each other in a row. When you are done, click Save and exit Design Mode. Click New to add new entry. Enter the general information at the top and then the details in the subtable. The subtable will initially show three empty rows for users to enter data. But when adding more subtable records, additional rows will appear. When I finish entering the third row and start to enter the fourth row, the fifth row will appear automatically. Since subtables will continuously expand to accommodate new entries, we recommend placing subtables at the bottom of your sheet design to avoid display issues. To get more information, subscribe to our channel and tap on the bell icon for the latest videos. If you have any questions, leave them below.